hope that you have had a wonderful day learning all about getting connected here at SMU. This morning we spent time talking about connecting you to the SMU academic reality and to the SMU Academy. We also discussed connecting to the SMU spirit, which is our values, history, and traditions. So we've learned a lot today about getting connected. As we mentioned tonight during our main stage dinner theater, we're going to talk about connecting to the SMU people. So we have two special parts of main stage dinner theater. The first is songs and dances that our students will share, our SMU songs and dances. And then we have some social issue vignettes, where we will talk about social issues that you may face as a college student. So I'm very excited to introduce to you the orientation leaders of 2017 for SMU songs.
Sit right there. I'll tell you how I became another world changer shaped here. On Dallas Hall lawn, born and raised, on the green grass is where I spent most of my days. Hammering, splashing, studying all cool, and playing some cornhole outside of the school. When a few horned frogs who were up to no good started making trouble on the boulevard. They started spitting words, and when the time came near, we said, we'll teach about the services that we got here. I whistled for a giddy up, and when it came near, the driver said, hey, there's nothing to fear. I thought to myself, this giddy was rare. But hey man, forget it's HT over there. I pulled up to Hughes Street a few minutes later, and to check out the boards, I took the elevator, saw student activities and almost a two, and thought to myself, there's a place for me and you. I hopped on the plane at DFW with my dream and my cowboy boots. Welcome to the Lone Star State, yee-haw! Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the Uber, here I am for the first time. Look to my right, see the Dallas skyline. This is all so crazy. Everybody seems so bougie. My time is turning and I'm feeling kind of homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. And when the Uber turns on the radio, and the varsity was on. And the varsity was on. And the varsity was on. I put my pony up to play my song. The homesickness goes away. Nodding my head like yeah. Moving my hips like yeah. So I put my pony up to play my song. I know it's gonna be okay. Yeah. It's a party in the GTX. Yeah. It's a party in the GTX. Yeah. It's a party in the GTX. Yeah, it's a party at SMU.
We obviously have a little bit of fun helping you get connected to SMU, but as we said, there are some serious topics that we want to address too as you get prepared to connect to SMU people. To start the more serious part of our discussion where we talk about social issues, we do have an orientation leader who is going to share his by SMU. Please help me welcome Kyle Baker.
My name is Kyle Baker, and this is my SMU. My SMU is Red Bricks. I remember touring campus for the first time and thinking, how can a place be so picture perfect? Looking around, I saw seemingly flawless building upon building. Everything was really exciting. But the campus was super intimidating. I got a lot of advice going to college. Go to class, read the book, don't join a cult. Above all, I heard college is a time to reinvent yourself, which can be true, but it will make SMU feel all the bigger. That is why I hope y'all use this time to be yourself. Hanging out on Dallas Hall lawn, you'll see lots of people who all look like they are perfect and have their entire lives together. But this is not the case. You see, the people at SMU are like the red bricks that make up its buildings. From a distance, each one looks identical, perfect and perfectly placed. Yet, take a closer look and you'll see that each one is different and has its own imperfections. Each one is being supported as it supports another. But when you take a step back, they make up a beautiful building. My point is it's okay to admit you don't have it all together. Be genuine with people, and they will not only respect you, but they will also help support you. Just like every brick has its place, every Mustang will be valued. Knowing this, SMU won't feel that big at all. That said, my favorite place at SMU is Humphrey Lee Dining Center at lunchtime, because I get to see all the red bricks that make up SMU. As everyone is scurrying around, I get to say hi and catch up with what makes SMU SMU. It's red bricks. That's my SMU. Build yours.
SMU orientation is here to connect you with the SMU learning environment, spirit, people, campus, and community of Dallas. This evening's presentation will hopefully acquaint you with some of the issues you may face while your time at college is here, whether those be social or academic.
Our goal is not to make you think that you'll face any of these issues on a daily basis, but to show you that a college community reflects trends in society. You'll be adjusting to a whole new life, new friends, new freedoms, new responsibilities, and new challenges.
This evening, we will present a few vignettes to help you as a new student and your family get a brief look at college life. Some will be funny and some will be serious, but all are designed to provoke discussion on various issues. And now, without further ado, the SMU orientation staff of 2017 proudly presents Main Stage Dip Theater.
Stories of students coming to SMU and learning things from each other and even more about themselves.
Listen to their stories so you can understand.
That college is more than cliches.
It's more than parties, all-nighters, and ramen noodles.
College is about keeping an open mind and seeing things differently.
It's about learning from new people and new experiences.
College is about making judgment calls and taking responsibility for your choices.
It's about understanding your values.
College is about becoming more independent,
even when you miss home.
It's about learning when to say yes and when to say no.
But most importantly, college is about deciding who you want to be. And what you decide will not only impact your experiences here at SMU, but forever.
Mom, being in college is so different from being in high school. There's just so much more to worry about. Responsibility, independence, fitting in. Having friends definitely helps ease the transition to SMU. And living in a commons has given me the opportunity to meet a lot of new people and let me learn about how alike and different we all are.
Wow, I can't wait for my new roommate to get here. We're gonna have so much fun this year.
Hi, I'm Zed.
I'm Darian. It's so nice to finally meet you. My parents are out at the car getting a few more boxes. What side of the room do you want? Mom, Dad, this is my new roommate, Zed.
Hi, Zed, nice to meet you. All right, I should tell you, Darian here is a slob. He can't cook and spends all of his time on Snapchat. So, tell me more about yourself. What's your major and where are you from? How long did it take you to get here? Are your parents here?
Honey, give him time to answer. Are you going to give all the campus organizations? What class are you taking? Darian's taking art history, and I'm just dying to read his textbook. It sounds very interesting. Did you know that SMU's Meadows Museum has a large collection of Spanish art outside of Spain?
You don't have to learn everything about him right this minute.
You're right. We'll have plenty of time. You know, your dad and I are thinking of coming to visit every single weekend.
I think that sounds great! I still remember the first time I saw your mother walking across the boulevard. Ugh. Please don't embarrass me right now.
All right. You know you're only kidding, Steve. Is there anything we can get you before we leave tonight, Biscuit?
Yes. Could you go to Target to get the stuff I need from there? Zen and I can continue to unpack here.
Sure. Zen, is there anything we can get you?
No. Thank you.
Alrighty then, I think I'm gonna go talk with your residential community director and faculty and residents to make sure they keep an eye on you two.
Honey, we have to start using that SMU lingo. What is it that they say? RCD and
Hey, I'm your RA Kaylee. Wow, your parents seem to care a lot about you.
Yeah, sometimes I think they care a little too much about me, you know what I mean? I'm so ready to be independent and live that college life. Although, it is kind of overwhelming thinking about all the classes I have to sign up for, all the new friends I have to make, living in a whole new place, and doing all the things my parents told me I should do while in college.
Well, remember, the college experience is for you, and not for your parents. You get to make your own choices, but you have to take responsibility for your choices.
That's true. My older brother is a senior here, and he said college really helps him figure out who he is, what he values, what his interests are, and what he wants to do with life.
You know what? I think you're right. Thanks.
Sure thing. Here's your roommate agreement form. This form will help you figure out how best to live together before issues arise. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me. I live right down the hall and can help with any issues or just how to get involved on campus.
Okay, great. Thanks, Katie.
No problem.
I guess we should start filling this out right now. The first question asks, at what time will the room be used for sleeping? I normally go to bed around midnight. Does that work for you?
I usually go to bed around 11 and prefer the room to be dark and quiet. Do you think we could work something out?
Sure. I can just go to the lounge and move up later than you. Can I use my desk lamp while getting ready for bed, though?
Sure. That seems like a word.
Sounds good.
Hey, Kaylee. Can you talk?
Hey, Zen. What's up?
Darren and I signed a roommate agreement and everything. He isn't really following it.
What's going on?
Well, he agreed that the room would be quiet starting at 11, but he always comes back so late and wakes me up because he's so noisy.
Have you tried talking to him about this?
Yeah. He apologized, but it's still happening.
Why don't both you and I go talk to him? I'll bring a copy of your roommate agreement form and see if we can figure something out.
That sounds great. Thanks.
No problem.
Conflicts with roommates are sure to arise. Be honest and detailed on your roommate agreement, and sticking to it can help eliminate some of these conflicts. The most important part is to communicate openly with your roommate. Make compromises, and if you have a hard time working things out, talk with an RA. Having a roommate is part of the college experience and a great way to get to know more about yourself and others.
Yeah, so you know how I had that test last week? I got a C on it. Yeah, I know, Mom, I need to study harder in college, but it's not that simple. It's so hard to say no to your friends when they ask to hang out. And there's something always going on here, every time, everywhere.
Ethan, dude, I just saw the funniest video on YouTube. You gotta check it out.
Alright, fine, but I only have a little bit of time, though. I have a huge midterm tomorrow.
It's not midterms already, is it?
It's halfway through the semester, so yeah, it is.
Oh, I should probably start studying for those then. Let's see, there's no exam in wellness, and I dropped chemistry last week. You know, that class was way harder than I thought it would be. That only leaves economics. Let's see. Tomorrow? What am I gonna do, Ethan? What am I gonna do?
Well, I'd study, but that's just me. Honestly, though, I don't know how you can expect to pass when you skip class all the time. You should probably start by doing the reading. That'll get you started. And if you have any more questions, you can see the peer academic leader.
So, what exactly is on the exam?
Chapters 5 through 7. It's in the syllabus.
Oh yeah, the syllabus. I haven't looked at that in a while. I should probably just start by reorganizing my class binder. Hey, Darian's going to Arnold. We should go.
Andy, you know Darian is just going to distract you. Order food and study with me here.
I'll be fine, and if worst comes to worst, I can just make a cheat sheet to use during the test.
What? No, Andy, you can't be serious.
Why not? It's not like the professor will see me.
Chances are your professor will see you. They look for cheating during tests. You could fail the test, maybe the class, and get an honor violation on your transcripts.
Wait, what's an honor violation?
It's a potential outcome of breaking SMU's honor code. The honor code exists to uphold the academic integrity of the university to make sure our degrees actually matter. Don't you remember completing the academic honesty tutorial?
Kinda. So you mean when I signed that, I agreed not to cheat?
Exactly. It says that if you cheat, plagiarize, help others cheat, or make up information, you could fail your course and maybe get an honor violation on your transcript. Some people get suspended or even expelled for this, and these stay on your transcript. They can stop you from getting a job or from getting into grad school.
Well, fine. If I can't cheat, just let me use some of your Adderall.
No, I have ADHD. I needed to focus and study.
Which is exactly what I need to do. Focus, then study. Come on, just this once.
I already told you no. Plus, it's illegal.
Fine.
Hey guys, what's up?
Hey, wanna go to Arnold's with Darian and I?
Actually, I have a really huge test tomorrow. I really have to study.
Really? Same. We should go meet up with Darian, then head over to Fondren.
Actually, I was planning on going to the A-Lab to go over the information with the tutor, just in case I had any questions.
You know what, Kaylee? That's a great idea. I think I'm gonna join you. Andy, just come with us.
Substance abuse is a problem at college campuses all across this nation. Even if you do not use drugs or drink, substance abuse can affect you through the people surrounding you. It is our responsibility, as students, to be aware of these issues and to make choices in line with the SMU values.
Wow, what's wrong with you?
I seriously hate SMU PD. I can't believe they arrested me during a boulevard. I just got back from the Office of Conduct and Community Standards, and during my officer hearing, I was found responsible for violating the alcohol policy and for failing to comply with a police officer. It's also the second time I was caught with a fake ID, and so now I'm on conduct probation. I have to see a substance abuse counselor in the health center, and I can't even go through recruitment in the spring. Who even cares if I was drunk on the boulevard? Everyone is.
Okay, I know this is probably only going to make you angrier, but I think it needs to be said. I saw you that day on the boulevard. You were out of control. You were stumbling around making a fool of yourself. The officer stopped you to make sure you were okay, and you started yelling at him, and you tried to run away.
Look, I really don't want to hear this from you right now.
And I really don't care. You think but honestly, you were embarrassing. But let me tell you something that you don't know. My best friend in high school died from alcohol poisoning. We all tried to help him, but by the time we got to the hospital, it was too late. I know you think that everyone is trying to ruin your fun and spoil your life, but that's because you only think about yourself. Have you ever stopped to think that the Office of Student Conduct and Community Standards is here to help us? I, for one, am glad that we have people and policies in place to keep us safe. Like I said, you were out of control that day, and honestly, it was embarrassing. We're all a part of SMU, and when people act like that, it makes us all look bad.
Look, I'm so sorry. I had no idea.
Of course you did. Look, sorry for yelling, but I think you needed to hear it. Go to your substance abuse counselor and try learning something, and consider that maybe you don't know everything. I need some air. I'll see you later.
It's a community that we're all a part of. In order to keep our community safe and healthy, SMU takes underage drinking very seriously. If the Office of Student Conduct and Community Standards is made aware of any violation of the Student Code of Conduct, a student will be notified that they have a conduct officer hearing.
During the hearing, the student will explain their side of the story. Later, the conduct officer will have a conversation about the incident. The conduct officer will determine if a student is responsible for the violations, and if so, assign sanctions. Sanctions are designed to help both the student learn from their actions and prevent future violations. If a student who is underage is found responsible for violating the alcohol policy, SMU will notify their parents. This meeting is separate from any additional legal process a student might be subject to.
Erica and I have been dating for about 2 months, and while we never talked about it, I made it clear that I was very attracted to her, and I thought that we would eventually have sex. I thought we were on the same page.
Adam and I had been dating for a while, and he always acted like the perfect gentleman. We'd done our fair share of making out, but he never did anything to make me like not to trust him. A few weeks ago, we were at a party. We were dancing and having a lot of fun. I got a little tired of the crowd, so I asked him if he wanted to go someplace we could be alone. Is that wrong?
While we were at the party, we danced a little. And when she said she wanted to find a place we could be alone together, I thought that we were both thinking the same thing. I thought that she was ready.
When we got alone, things were going further than ever before. I said I didn't want them to go any further, but I didn't want to scream. The next thing I knew, he was forcing me to have sex with him, and it was horrible. Everything I said and did clearly meant no. Couldn't he tell I didn't want to?
Of course I thought she wanted to have sex. Granted, she hesitated a little at first, but I just figured she wanted to be persuaded. Don't women want men to take the initiative? I don't know. We had sex, and after the party, I took her home, and ever since then, she refuses to talk to me or even go out with me. I thought that she really liked me. I thought thought everything was okay.
Needless to say, I never want to see Adam again. I thought he really cared about me. What happened?
One in five college women has had an experience which classifies as sexual violence. Women ages 16 to 24 run a greater risk of experiencing sexual assault than any other population group. However, this is not just a problem for women. 10% of males will experience sexual assault in their lifetimes. 50 to 75% of sexual assault is influenced by drug or alcohol use, and 80% of sexual assault is committed by an acquaintance. It is important to remember that anybody who is incapacitated due to drug or alcohol use cannot give consent.
If you are sexually assaulted during your time here at SMU, there are many options you can go to for help. You can go to counseling services, the Dean of Student Life Office, the Healthcare Center, the Women and LGBT Center, the Chaplain's Office, Violent Prevention and Student Service Office, or the SMU PD. Individuals in these offices can support and discuss your options with you. You can even get medical assistance if necessary. Remember, sexual assault should not be taken lightly.
While the scene that we just acted out is a fictional scenario, it highlights the important role consent plays in any physical relationship. Consent means voluntary, clear, continuous, mutually understandable permission given by words or actions regarding one's willingness to have sex. Also, consent is a complicated issue. Alcohol only makes it even more difficult.
As students, we believe so strongly in maintaining a safe campus that we've adopted the Not On My Campus campaign to remind students that sexual violence is unacceptable and will not be tolerated at SMU.
Furthermore, SMU takes all allegations of sexual misconduct seriously and requires students, faculty, staff, and others to report any known occurrence of sexual misconduct to our Office of Institutional Access and Equity and our Title IX coordinator. The federal government also requires that SMU investigate any known occurrence of sexual assault in order to make sure our campus remains safe.
We hope if you experience any form of sexual violence, including sexual assault, intimate partner violence, harassment, and or stalking, that you consider your options, seek help, talk to someone, and inform those on our campus who can keep you and others safe.
A few final reminders. Consent is a complicated issue, and alcohol makes it even more complicated. Drunk sex is risky sex.
When it comes to the physical aspect of any relationship, aim for enthusiasm, not just consent. While consent is a must, you really shouldn't want to be physical with someone who's just giving in.
Finally, spend time considering what you want from relationships. Spend time considering what you think, believe, and value about sex and relationships.
Totally start over and remake themselves. While part of this is true, the reality is, when you come to college, you bring everything you are with you. This is your beliefs, your values, ideals, and experiences. This is also your hurts, losses, and struggles.
Hey, Will, I got your text. What's up?
Hey, thanks for meeting me. You know, during Arrow, you told us we could always ask you for help, and I finally wanted to take you up on the offer. This is kind of hard for me to talk about, but in high school I struggled with an eating disorder, and my parents helped me get treatment before it got out of control, and I haven't really struggled with it since, but lately I've noticed myself going down an unhealthy path, and I don't really want to do that anymore, but I don't know what to do. Everyone here seems like they have it all together.
Well, thanks for sharing. It means a lot that you trust me with this. Okay, so a couple of things. First off, no one has it all together. I've had lots of friends who have dealt with similar things and lots of other things.
That's kind of hard to believe. Everyone here seems basically perfect.
No, really.
I struggle with exercise bulimia.
I struggle with alcoholism.
I struggle with anxiety.
I struggle with an addiction to painkillers.
I struggle with depression.
Thank you.
I thought everyone had it all together too. But like you said, it's not easy to talk about the hard things. We prefer to hide them.
I guess I hadn't thought about it like that before.
I got diagnosed with diabetes my first year in college and really struggled with how to process it. Since I was involved in one of SMU's campus ministries, my friends decided to tell me to go talk to the SMU chaplain. I'm really glad that they did. He helped me process my diagnosis in a healthy way, which ultimately helped me improve my physical health as well. My point is, one of the best things about SMU is how many offices, people, and groups are here to help us. Unfortunately, there are so many resources, sometimes it seems like the end of one of those pharmaceutical commercials.
If you or someone you know is struggling, there's help for you. Don't hesitate to reach out to the resources at Counseling Services, the Chaplain's Office, the Dean of Student Life Office, Caring Community Connection, your Residential Community Director, Residential Community Chaplain, Resident Assistant, the Office of Institutional Access and Equity, Women in LGBT Center, and many more. They're here to help.
Yeah, I know there are resources, but I don't know where to start.
Which is exactly the right thing. After being on campus for a year now, I know quite a bit, but I don't know everything. My best friend is an RA. They're super knowledgeable about campus resources. Let's go talk to him and see what he knows.
Campuses across the nation continue to work to help students cope with the challenges. SMU has many resources available to help students remain healthy spiritually, physically, and mentally. The most important thing you can do is to ask for help. Remember, don't struggle alone.
Hey Leslie, have you seen that new College Students Read Mean Tweets video?
No, but I've seen it all over Facebook. Let's watch it right now. I can pull it up.
Women should only be allowed one career option. Housewife.
Hashtag Black Lives Matter. Only on my fantasy football team.
Do Asians have other jobs besides restaurant owner or nail lady?
I hope my roommate isn't gay. What if he tries to kiss me?
I'm so sick of hearing all these rich kids complain about life. Please stop. You don't have real problems.
It's way too hot in the South for a full burqa. Stop letting men oppress you and just wear shorts.
Minorities have it so easy. They literally can play the race card for anything that upsets them. Where's my affirmative action?
That video was so funny. They really nailed that thing about minorities right on the head.
Daniel, are you serious? I think you missed the point of the video. This was highlighting hurtful things that have been shared on college campuses across the nation. This wasn't meant to be funny.
Honestly, Daniel, I would have laughed too, but since coming to college, I've learned a lot about respecting people of diverse backgrounds. These kinds of things used to make me laugh because I simply didn't understand them. But getting involved with the Office of Multicultural Student Affairs and programs such as Real Talks and Intersections Retreat has helped me learn a lot about different viewpoints and experiences.
Come on, guys. Y'all are taking this way too seriously. It's just a video.
That's because this is serious. What may be a joke to you is actually someone's life experience. I think this video is so important on our campus because Mustangs come from various walks of life, and it's the least we could do to respect someone even if their background is different than ours. Too often we're quick to judge others based on their own perceptions of life, when really the sooner we realize that everyone experiences life differently, the sooner we can learn from everyone around us.
Exactly, Hannah. Don't you remember what we learned at Camp Corral? Every Mustang will be valued. I want to do my part to make sure I take college as an opportunity to learn about other people. This is a wonderful time to form friendships with people from all over. Daniel, if you come to college and don't take advantage of interacting with everyone, you will lose out on so many meaningful experiences.
I mean, I guess.
Listen, just think about how you would feel if everyone assumed things about you based on the way you look or speak. This respect you want is the same respect you should give, and part of this respect is not allowing our personal biases to hinder our ability to get to know someone.
Are you saying I don't respect people?
No, Daniel. She's saying to be aware of your opinions and think about how your worldview may affect other people. People can have differences of opinion, but it's important to engage in open, respectful dialogue before joking about things that aren't your own life experience. Not only should we take this seriously, we should know that SMU takes this seriously.
You're right. SMU has an anti-discrimination policy, which reinforces our university's commitment to not tolerate discrimination on the basis of race, color, religion,
national origin, age, sex, genetic information, disability status, sexual orientation, gender identity, and expression. I'm so thankful to our university for valuing students from all walks of life. On another note though, it's been a while since I've had something to eat, and I'm getting a little bit hangry. So how about we continue this conversation over lunch? Anyone down for a Max Place run?
That's a great idea. Let's go get some food.
College presents many opportunities to make life-changing decisions. This is a time for you to discover and gain greater appreciation of others for who they are. Many students begin the semester by making assumptions about their teachers and classmates. Instead, students should recognize the importance of understanding and accepting the diversity of our society and our world. At SMU, we work to look past stereotypes and appearances, recognizing that everyone brings something valuable to our community.
Part of our everyday lives. As you enter college, it's important to consider what your online presence tells others about you and how important it is to remember that cameras are everywhere.
Thank you so much for allowing me to interview for this position. This will be my first full-time job after college, and I really want to work for this company.
Well, it's a pleasure getting to meet you. I think you're very well suited for this position at our company. I'll be sure to keep in contact with you about the details of your employment. Ah, I love hiring SMU grads, but I just have to make sure there are no red flags. So let me just do a quick Google search and... Okay! Ooh. She is kicking Peruna. Okay. She clearly has some judgment issues. I'm gonna have to go with a different candidate.
Hannah, I've been meaning to tell you about my friend Will I met a couple months ago. I think you two would really hit it off. You both love community service, marathons, and dancing.
Those are like three of my favorite things. Let's pull up his Twitter and see what he's all about. Jeez, everything's a nasty jab at someone, or something really negative. I could never date someone who says such awful things to people while hiding behind a screen.
Wow, that's so weird. He's so chill in person. I never would have expected that.
Mr. Jones, Professor Jones, I just wanted to thank you so much for this letter of recommendation for grad school. Ever since I took your econ class, I've just been really excited for grad school. Did I mention I'm going to grad school because of your letter of recommendation?
Ooh, yeah, you sure did. And I love writing letters for students, as you know. I'm actually going to go to my office right now and put the finishing touches on it.
Great. Thanks again.
All right. I just want to put a little more in there about that one service organization he's in, but I can't quite remember the name of it. Let's check Facebook. Whoa, nothing here about any service organization. Just him looking totally wasted on the boulevard and what can only be described as vandalizing campus property. Wow, looks like I'm gonna have to remove mature and responsible from this recommendation letter. What a shame.
All right, well, it's the end of the year, so you know what that means. It's time to select replacements for president and vice president of our honorable organization, SMU, Sigma, Mu, Upsilon.
Yeah. After interviews, Darian and Adam are definitely our top candidates. We should just check their social media to make sure there are no red flags.
Cool. You check their Instagram and I'll check their Snap stories.
Yeah, well, Darian's Instagram is pretty chill, and Adam's is just a bunch of pictures of food.
Yeah, Darian's story is mainly... face swaps and animal filters. Adam's looks good. Hold on. Wait, on Kyle's story, there's a video of Adam yelling at a security guard at a concert. He looks so sloppy and out of control.
Looks like we'll have to move on to the next candidate.
There are two important things to remember. One,
Be aware about what your online presence says about you, because two, people will judge you based on what they find on the internet.
Many first-year students, when they arrive on campus, is not being accepted or fitting in. College is very different from high school, but making friends helps to make the transition easier and more fun. Mustang Corral alleviates the apprehension of feeling uncomfortable and begins the college journey. It all starts at Corral.
Can you believe we're all already seniors? Do you remember how scared we were when we were first years? When I first got here, I had no idea that there were so many things to do and so many different kinds of people.
I know. Look at this awesome class of 2021. They have 4 whole years ahead of them.
It all goes by so fast. I just wish we had more time.
If I don't pass this advanced astrophysics class, I will have more time here.
A lot of people go to college for 1 to 4 years.
Yeah, they're called doctors.
Hey, Ethan, weren't you my orientation leader?
Oh, hey, Daniel, how have you been?
Oh, it's going fantastic. I just finished unpacking my room today, and I've met so many new people, especially in Mustang Corral. You know, the thing is, I just haven't found that group that I really clicked with yet, though.
I found that getting involved in my comments really helped me feel more connected.
Wow, you really think that'll help?
It couldn't hurt.
Yeah, getting involved on Commons Council really helped me feel more connected to the community.
I also loved intramurals. Maybe you should try that.
Yeah, you should sign up for a team. Just talk to one of your RAs. They're great resources.
You know, that sounds like a great idea. I always love scoring those baskets.
Another great way is by joining student organizations. You can find out all the information at orgs.smu. I've met some of my best friends by joining these organizations.
Well, no matter what you're interested in, there's a group here for you at SMU.
Being involved on campus is not just something to fill your weekly schedule. At SMU, learning is everywhere. Plus, being involved on campus makes you more marketable. Employers are always looking for people who have taken on leadership experience and experience on campus in general. So make sure to stop by a night at the club after Mustang Corral to find your place at SMU.
College is one of the most exciting times in your life. Take advantage of meeting new friends, trying new things, learning everything you can, and becoming a new you in the process. While at SMU, you'll become prepared for the next chapter in your life.
Thank you.
right, we hope you enjoyed Main Stage Dinner Theater. Yeah, we can give another round of applause. As you can tell, that the orientation team spent a lot of time making those songs and dances and the social issue vignettes great for you. We know that we are starting those conversations and that those will be continued. So students, you'll have an opportunity to debrief the skits that you saw here today. This evening, parents and families, we hope that you'll engage your students in conversations about the topics that we brought up. We do want to give you a reminder that the skits are skits, so those are not stories about their personal lives. When they share their My SMU stories, those are their stories, but the skits are just issues, or skits about issues that they may face in college. So just want to clarify that for you. So we have some important information to give you about the rest of the evening and about tomorrow morning. So we want to give you some instructions about what to expect. But while we let our orientation leaders grab some dinner, we're going to give you a chance to check in with your students. So you're going to have about 10 minutes to chat with your parents and your families before students, we lead you to SMU Late Night and before we dismiss parents and families to our SMU Parent Family Social. So you will have about 10 minutes in here. We'll turn on some music, catch up with your student about the day, and then we'll be back to give you instructions for tomorrow.